Would you address the question of nourishing the child so that the child can learn when he or she gets to school? I'm concerned about problems of undernutrition and whether your primary health care plans will address questions of nutrition of children.
You know, what we want to now influence, and we want government to pay for it. There's a very interesting scheme in India in as part of education, which I think is now being repeated by many other countries in the world, of a free midday meal by the government schools. And it's part of the whole budget. And it's a significant part of the whole budget. And it's a decent meal, because many companies like us, or many foundations like us, have got involved in community advocacy on it, so that the meal gets supervised by the women when it is being cooked and when it is being served. It's localized and being cooked, so the ingredients are centrally shipped. And it's a decent meal, because I've had that very often. It's a simple meal, it's a vegetarian meal, but it's a balanced meal, because we have a lot of lentils in India, and that combined with vegetables is a decent meal. But what is required is a supplement of some vitamins, which help in just a balance of what the body requires, which is often very absent. And that's what we want to influence. That is part of the midday meal budget, put this in. And if they don't agree to putting this into the budgets, influence policy at a senior level, push back from the villages at a senior level, push back from leadership at a senior level, to be able to achieve this. That's one element of extra hygiene in the midday meal for the child. The second area is in the area that of sanitation standards and health standards of cleanliness, which one very often does not find, which is again educating the village mother, the importance of that for the little children which are in the house, the newborn child which is going to be there. And generally a discipline that, you know, you don't take the garbage from your house and throw it into the neighbor's garden, which sometimes happens, and issues which are related to that. The third area of involvement would be in very, very poor families. How do we get involved in a much more deep manner? We're trying to figure that out, because we just got our hands terribly full of trying to do what we are doing and now trying to get this university up and about, because we have set very tight deadlines on it. And we will work much more actively with organizations such as the Bill Gates Foundation. We are in dialogue with them, because they're doing some good work at a grassroots level, and so are other companies. But what we've got to be careful of is not a very close association with multinationals as a foundation, because it just takes all kinds of side things when somebody wants to hit you in terms of opposition, which Muhammad Yunus is facing now in Bangladesh, and very seriously, because I just talked to him 4 or 5 days back. And we are very, 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 very careful that we are very low-key. So all the work which we do, we give the credit to the state authorities, the state bureaucrats, and the state politicians. Because generally, they're doing the good work. And generally, the people who work with us are the people who really stand out in terms of a conviction to do good work. And it makes no difference to us, and we get their support going forward. We don't want that to get diluted with the politics.